This is all I ever wanted for you, Will. For both of us.
Yeah, they did a real, you know, they did an almost, you know, the actors were kind of having fun with it. And they got to a point for sure where, you know, it was a loving gaze into each other's eyes before they went off. And it was sort of reminiscent of the end of season two, you know, plus. You know, so it was certainly giving power to certain theories about this.
It's beautiful.
One of the things I find weird about the show, I mean, the show's got its own logic. It's its own world, and you can't really, it operates under its own rules. But like the homoerotic tension between Will and Hannibal is crazy. But no one ever says like, did you guys fuck already? Like, no one ever says, I think Hannibal's interest is a little gay. It's never said. Like even Jack, who you expect would go, what the fuck's going on? I mean, what's he want with you? You know what I mean?
The love between Hannibal and Will has always been, you can feel it, but it's never been addressed in a very, it's never been explained. That's what I like about Brian's writing.
One of our first emotional moments with Will Graham is him rescuing a stray dog on the side of the road, and we see that this damaged man has great capacity to care about those around him. And after killing Francis Dolarhyde with Hannibal Lecter, he realizes this is exactly what Hannibal Lecter has wanted all along. He has wanted a partner in crime, a murder husband, as it were. And the sad truth of it all is Hannibal was right. Will did enjoy it. Will thought it was a beautiful, powerful thing. And in that realization that what they experienced together was beautiful, Will realizes that his return to humanity is going to be so much more difficult than he ever anticipated. So this should be his end of humanity. And off they go.
It's beautiful.